Hi, I'm Evelyn, a Poetry Society young critic reviewing A Change in the Air by Jane Clarke, which was shortlisted for the 2023 T.S. Eliot Prize. Held together by gravity and friction, hearted by handfuls of spools. A Change in the Air is tightly packed, taking shards of pain and piecing them together to form a cohesive collection which is rooted in tenderness. Exploring what it means to connect with each other and our surroundings against a shifting cultural background, Clarke's poems are filled with quiet moments of humanity and a constant respect for her subject matter. In the opening sequence of this collection, she exists in a space between losses and navigates it against a series of domestic and agricultural acts. The shift from childhood observations to drawing comfort from them herself marks her change in responsibilities. In Raspberries, she writes, "A pound of sugar for every pound of fruit says I must remember because something has slipped into her mind and every night, like a stoat among voles, it hunts down her memories." This closing line captures an uneasy sense of vulnerability. And throughout all of the collection, she displays a remarkable ability to pinpoint experiences against the universality of nature. She uses this precision of imagery to ensure that although the poems sit with the pain of her mother's memory loss, they still speak the loudest at moments of connection. The horse chestnut gives us shelter from drizzle that brings a million drops of rain. Clarke reminds the reader that future loss doesn't negate the joy of the present. A rediscovered delight in hot potatoes can still be delight despite the forgetting. There is space for the complicatedness of it all. She dives like a cormorant dives, leaves only a circle of bubbles. We listen for where shall emerge. Since Clarke describes her work as word music, it is fitting the way this describes the collection itself. A Change in the Air is made up of six sequences and darts like the cormorant between ideas. Closing with powerful images that encapsulate the content, these poems linger like the disruption of water in the reader's mind. They typically follow a concise and lilting couplet structure that recalls the rhythmic patter of rain against a roof, leaving you soothed and warm. This is not to say she is unsuccessful when she deviates from this form. Take the poem You Could Say It Begins. It sprawls across the page and through the Irish countryside to, as with the border itself, form a separation between parts. Passing in a rush of verbs and places, it provides a sense of constant motion through which the reader traverses the border until it meets the sea, where You Could Say It Ends, or maybe it begins. Reminiscent of Alice Oswald's Dart, it is rooted in interviews and lived experiences, with the geographical feature becoming more than itself. But this closing line reminds the reader of the differences between the two. Although rivers may be the original form of border, there is no longer a given flow. Clarke has shown that the journey the poem has taken, and perhaps the border itself, is arbitrary. This impact is felt throughout the rest of the sequence, ripples of ideas connecting in concentric rings. When we encounter a moss-mantled boulder, our interaction is altered despite no tangible change. Considering the scope of this collection, it could easily become disconnected, but instead the reader is continuously grounded by that which surrounds us, neighbours, rivers, and the resilient heather. Across both time and place, Clarke shows us that taking care of the land is taking care of each other, is taking care of ourselves. With its ambiguous title, A Change in the Air is asking us to engage with what that means as our environmental situation changes. It gently takes your hand, says, yes, the water may be cold, but remember how important everything is. Feel the current that takes you. Alert, electric, alive.